Whew. Spending the last 2 months of my life building animated stream overlays, putting them all together in Streamlabs OBS, creating matching panels with them, creating install files so it takes like 5 seconds to install it after you've downloaded it, and creating all the graphic assets so that people in OBS can use it as well, has been brutal. But at least I'm gonna make a lot of money off it.
Sorry, cut. We had a script revision. These are free.
Hey everybody, my name is LJ with streamscheme.com. I'm also a variety streamer over at twitch.tv/LJM_. Link in the description to both of those, as well as something truly special. That is right, today I'm gonna be showing you how to install our fully animated overlays that we've spent the last 2 months creating for you guys. There'll be a link in the description to that, but before you go ahead and download it, let's watch this video and show off some of the work we've done and how to install it. Now onto the show and tell portion of our video. First up, we have the Paint Splatter Pack. This gritty textured pack is kind of inspired by the idea of graffiti or paint on a nice kind of concrete wall. And then we thought, what about the Power Rangers as well? And we just chucked in one of each color, then light and dark mode it so it fits any stream. Thanks to the color variety, I really believe that this overlay can fit anyone whatsoever, but it also has that bit of edge and kick to it if you're a bit more of a hardcore gamer. So next up, we have an overlay that I've never kind of seen this style before, but I hope it's great for you guys, is this chilled out cherry blossom season. Keep it cool, relaxed, and make sure you enjoy that Stardew Valley, Animal Crossing, or even just chatting vibe. It's a nice little difference, and I think you guys will really enjoy it. And finally, my favorite of our three designs, inspired by the 90s Rugrats and modern shape styles, we have got Old School Cool. A lot of different inspirations from a lot of different places from this, as I said, 90s Rugrats, but we also took some comic book shading. The entire thing is animated. It is honestly my favorite overlay we've made. It even has matching panels for it. I'm a little bit jealous that you guys get this for free because I spent about $15 USD on my stream package, and I honestly think that this one looks better. All three of these overlays and all of their color variants come with a quick and easy install process. They come with every scene you already need pretty much set up, preview files, graphic assets, so it's completely modular. You can add and remove whatever you want. They come with panels, support bars, social bars. And if you're using Streamlabs OBS, I've even set up all of the stream labels for you. So when you load up, all you have to do is select which pack of bars you want, and then you're good to go. Every new follower will appear, every new sub, every new donation, it doesn't matter. I've put a lot of time into these for you guys. I've lost my mind a little bit. To the OBS users, please don't worry though, I have also included every single graphic asset for you so you can build it out as you see fit and whatever you need. Speaking of setting up all the graphics and everything like that, I wanna throw it out there before I show you guys how to install all of these things, which we will be covering in a second. If you enjoyed this video, if you like these overlays, check out the other content on our channel. We have a lot of other videos about all things Twitch, all things streaming, and if those help you, maybe consider subscribing, maybe consider liking. Seriously, I'm just here trying to help you guys out. Plus, if you subscribe, you'll know when we release our second pack of free overlays, because that is on the horizon. I've already started the next set. I think there's something wrong with me. So onto the first steps, the tutorial, downloading and extracting. Let's get over to the computer. So first things first, you're gonna download the pack and you'll receive a zip file like this. Once you've extracted that, you'll be met with four folders. The first contains all of the graphic assets for the overlay, the background, headlines, webcam borders, support bars, social bars, stingers, all of that jazz. It will also have all the fonts that you will need. Now, I need to stress this for you right now. Make sure the first step you do is install all the fonts onto your computer. I've supplied them for you so you're not gonna go hunting for anything, but if you don't install the fonts, none of these overlays will look proper when you install them. It'll be confused. So install those fonts, then move on from this. We also included the hex codes for all the colors used in each pack, and finally some preview files to show you what each scene should look like if you do wanna get a bit modular and then you need to turn it back at all. So go ahead, get those fonts installed quickly. Yes, I'm saying it again. And I'm gonna quickly talk about the hex codes. Now those hex codes, you don't really need them whatsoever. However, if you wanna add your own text, your own widgets, whatever you wanna do, or if you're in, for example, OBS, and you wanna edit a lot of stuff, the hex codes are there just so you have your colors matching. If you wanna put text in, the text has to be the same blue as whatever other thing in the pack, then the hex code will be in the folder there and you can make sure it matches up. Pretty easy. Now, after the graphics asset folder, you're gonna see this folder here. This is just a link to this video so that if you get lost, you can always come back and use it as a tutorial. But after that, you're gonna have the Streamlabs quick install guide. Now for the OBS users, don't worry, we're gonna get to you guys in a second, but we'll cover this first. Make sure you check the time codes if you just wanna skip ahead. Once you have your fonts installed, yes, I am gonna say it to you again, if you are a Streamlabs OBS user, head over to Streamlabs, hit the little cog in the lower left-hand side of your screen, click Scene Collection in the menu, and select Import Overlay File. Head over to the extracted zip you downloaded and find the folder named Streamlabs OBS Overlay. Open that up and click the .overlay file and then hit open. Now this is the true power of Streamlabs OBS right here. It has built-in theme installation. I'm not joking, this is the best thing I've ever seen. The fact that you can just click this button and install all this work I put into it is amazing. It has the stream labels, it has everything other than the widgets already put into it. That is wild. Once that is done, the first thing you're gonna wanna do is go through and start editing all of your social headers and all of your stream labels to match what you want them to be. All you have to do is just double click on them and change them out. I'd also recommend deleting the welcome screen now because that'll just take up more CPU to have that scene loaded and you'll be good to go. After all of that, you should be good to go. You can have a little explore around. Good work, Slobs users, you're fully installed and good to set up your webcams or whatever else you need. Now you have a play with it while I get the OBS users all up and running and then we'll jump into panels and the final touches. So for the OBS users, it is a little bit different and I have to apologize. I wish I could make it as easy for you guys for Slobs, but because OBS is built differently, we can't make it as quick and easy to install. However, we've come up with a system, so let's get back over to the computer. As I said, I wish I could have given you a .overlay file like Slobs users, but sadly OBS doesn't have something like that available for a small team like ours. So instead, we've provided you with these preview files. What you can do is import these into OBS and then import the individual assets from the graphic asset folder and line them up. It's kind of like putting together a puzzle piece or a set of puzzle pieces. But the best part about this is if you don't want to use a just chatting segment or anything like that, you can kind of just pick and choose what you want. It becomes very modular. So open up OBS, make sure you have a whole new overlay pack set up. So this is like completely fresh. All you have to do is get a new scene set up and then you're going to hit the plus button down the bottom of your source section here. Now, if you're adding one of our static images, for example, a PNG, you'll select image in this dropdown. If you're adding one of our animated WebM files, then you'll click media source. The best way to know whether or not you're adding a PNG or a WebM is really just to figure out whether or not it's animated or whether or not it's static. One is an image, one's a video file, essentially. Once you have selected it, a second window will appear. You'll title the asset you're planning to open, such as social media. Find the asset you want to use in the next window, open it up, and it has been added right here. It's pretty easy, and honestly, part of it's actually not too bad. The fact you have to install all these things by hand for OBS, it means you'll get very familiar with using your overlay, and you can pick and choose whatever you want. If you want a guide, as I said, just import the preview files, and you can add a filter for color correction, lower the opacity down to 50%, and you can use that as like a top layer as you line everything up underneath it. And finally, the last of the four folders, you have the panels folder. Now, this doesn't really matter for someone who's on YouTube or Facebook, because I don't think you guys have panels, but if you're a Twitch user, we've gone ahead and created you custom panels that fit everything, including adding a blank one so you can add your own. All you have to do is go on that folder, find the panel you want to install, and just drop it into the panels underneath your Twitch stream. As I said, the blank one is there, so if you want to add your own header or whatever you need to do, go for it. If you have any issues, questions, or you just want to say thanks, then hop over to my Twitch stream, chuck it in the comments, or check us out on Twitter. The Discord will be up and running hopefully by this video, so check that in the description as well, where we're going to be doing streamer support. And overall, make sure you subscribe, because I'm going to create content weekly, more overlays are on their way, and I hope you guys have a great day.